items of the weekend rather. And boy, oh boy, do we have it at a special. It's small but mighty. If it can crush a can.
Yes.
The big thing here is food is money.
Yep.
And we're throwing away more food than we want to. And nobody wants to do that, Kelly, but until this, there hasn't been an affordable, portable, practical way.
I love the word portable.
It is portable.
It's so small.
Yes.
If you've ever bought or purchased those food sealing systems, they're about as big as your countertop.
Yes.
And they take up the whole underneath cabinet, and they're about $200, and you always have to rebuy their bags.
Yes.
Okay, so you're getting 24 reusable dishwasher safe bags. And you can buy extra bags of ours if you'd like. But I want to show you the difference. With those other machines, it just eliminates the air and it squishes everything.
Right.
That's great for things like protein, but what if you want to do your berries,
sure,
like your strawberries or your blueberries?
Yeah.
There's a little little trigger here, and all you do is you align the little suction cup with the red dot, and watch, I control. I'm not crushing my berries, but I'm removing enough air so that they won't go bad. So let's say these are organic blueberries and they cost me $500,000. You want to preserve these. They're so expensive.
That's no joke.
Same with your strawberries, though, or your raspberries. So with those big food saving systems, you would never put your berries in them.
Do you know what you
actually scared me? It would just turn it to berry mush.
But what's, because I actually, back in the day, as they say, I have one of those really
big ones.
Big ones.
Yep.
And when I saw you do strawberries, I thought, oh, Kelly.
No.
I mean, you could
never crush it.
Do that with one of those.
Okay, let's say you eat a half an avocado in your salad. The other half you blink and it's brown.
Sure.
Remove the air, put it inside one of these, because you're going to use it the next day or the next day.
For sure.
And you can see how fresh it stays. Now, these are reusable. When I say reusable, these are not single use, throw in the garbage, grab another one. When I take this avocado out and I use the other half, or maybe I use both of them, the way I do it is I take it, I turn it inside out, put it on top rack of my dishwasher.
Oh, sure.
It will eliminate all odors.
Yep.
It will eliminate colors. You can reuse these over and over. You can sous vide in these. They're boil safe.
Yes.
These are BPA free bags.
Oh, I'm gonna do that.
And you're also getting the zippy tie thing, the clip.
Okay.
That's the official name. You go across it. You can do it with your fingers, but this just makes sure that it is officially closed for sealing, so that every last drop of air that you want to remove can be removed.
For sure. Hey, I do want to let you know, though, if you want the additional bags, I'm going to say
There's the boxes right there for you.
Yep. So get the additional bags, because the thing is, we don't always have the additional bags.
No, you're right. They usually sell out.
They do. So we have the 1 quart, and we also have the 1 gallon available. So special Labor Day pricing, of course. And, you know, the one thing that we can say for sure, it's like death and taxes, you're going to use bags.
Yeah, you're going to use bags.
You're gonna
use
bags.
And they're reusable over and over and over. This is not like the single use, you know, machine. So I've seen the other machines. They're big, they're clunky, they're cumbersome, and you have to keep rebuying, and they're single use plastic, right?
Yeah.
These are not single use. I've used mine dozens of times or more.
Yeah.
So this is all you do is you take your bag, you put whatever it's on the inside. Maybe it's your bagels, maybe it's your English muffins, maybe it's your croissants, maybe it's your protein, and you're gonna freeze it. Whatever you wanna do, and then you just zip this right across.
Yep.
I always go twice for safety.
Okay.
You can use your thumb and your fingers if you'd like, and then all you do is align that suction, and then you can see it will immediately start to remove the air, and then it will remove as much air as you choose, because it's not, I mean, you have complete control. So now the oxygen is not going to degrade that. It's the same with your herbs are so incredibly expensive.
Oh, Lord, I know.
And when you buy them, you have to buy so much, especially cilantro. They give you these massive bunches of cilantro. And unless you're running a catering company, your family's probably not going to use that much cilantro in one sitting.
For sure.
So pop it in one of your bags, open it up each and every time. The resealable, reusable, let's say I need a couple of leaves of basil. And then each and every time I reseal it, I take that extra 2 or 3 seconds, reseal it, and now my basil's going to last till Christmas.
That
I mean, probably
so
not really.
Right, but
seriously, there's no air in there.
Yeah.
Look at its paper thin.
Because air is not, well, anybody's friend, but you have to remember, we say no bags to buy. Yes, you can reuse them, but get extra bags, but no batter.
I would grab a couple extra. You're getting a dozen of the small and a dozen, and a dozen goes quickly.
Right.
Because you're going to start to put your chicken breast in it, and it's going to be in the freezer. How about your bagels or your croissants, your English muffins? I mean, I love fresh bread from the bakery, but because there's no preservatives, which is a good thing, it goes bad really, really quickly. And you can see right here, look, it looks like I've squished them, but when you open it up, look at all of that fluffing back up.
But you know what? You can get very precise.
Yes,
so you can remove
control.
As much or as little air as you want.
Exactly.
And you know, the truth of the matter is, when it comes to packaging in stores, if you'll notice, you know how they have those individual flash frozen chicken breasts and steaks and things like that? the reason they're more money is you're paying for the packaging.
You're paying for the packaging.
You're paying for the packaging. And now you can do this not only for portion control, whether it's assisted living, empty nesters, or if it's the avid fisherman,
yes,
hunter.
If you're gifting this to a fisherman or a hunter,
they can
take this out into the field and actually, as they process the fish, pop it into the bags and reseal it and then take it home and freeze it and give that away. And the truth is, you know, people that hunt and fish, they have to have the food saving systems.
Yes, they do.
Because then what else do you do with all those that catches that you have? But you have to seal it up, but they're not going to take the big clunky one.
No, they're not.
The other thing I use it for, and people laugh because I tell them I use it every day. I use it every day on my coffee.
Oh, yeah.
Because the reason, and here's the true story. This is how we buy coffee. It's vacuum packed and vacuum sealed. First scoop of coffee tastes amazing. Second scoop, pretty good. Third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, all the way to your 20th scoop, it starts to taste stale. If you're a coffee snob, you then quit using your own coffee and you start going to the coffee shop.
You do.
You could, if you just had fresh coffee every day because you resealed it after every couple of scoops, you would stop going to the coffee shops.
You would.
Because we go to the coffee shops because they have fresh ground coffee.
Absolutely.
Their coffee is not exposed to oxygen every day like yours is. So if you're keeping it in anything other than a vacuum sealed, resealed, that, you know, factory sealed container, your coffee will taste like fresh ground coffee.
It will. And you know, and I'm embarrassed to say, but you know, I'm so weird in particular about taste and flavor. I have thrown away things if I feel like it tastes stale or if it's not as crispy or if it's not as fresh tasting.
It's so true.
And this really, it locks in that flavor profile. You will save money. That's number one.
Well, you really will. Sure. Just as this example, buy one, get one free on, you know, five chicken breasts.
Yeah.
That's a $21 value, but it's not a value if I have to throw this away because it's freezer burnt.
Exactly.
This is now going to go in the garbage because this is not intended to store it. So if you take that extra maybe 30 seconds, 50 seconds, 2 minutes, and go individual on the chicken breasts, or you could do three or four at a time, and marinate them before you pop them in, and then you're never gonna get the freezer burn, because freezer burn is that frozen air hitting our food. It's not gonna get any air on the inside, and then when you go to take this out and pressure cook it or put it on your grill, it's already marinated. So just take the couple extra seconds, take those reusable bags. The bags can go in the dishwasher, so
That's smart.
I finish this flat of chicken breast, inside out, dishwasher safe, I can reuse it.
It is so smart. And remember, again, you don't have to buy any batteries. We are recommending more bags, more bags, more bags.
I would pick up a couple of those boxes just because we never have them in stock.
No, we don't.
Yes.
And that's why I say, when we do have the bags available, do make sure that you get additional ones, because that is the one thing we can tell you for sure, is you will use it and you will use your bags. And I love your idea about sous vide. And
yes, you can sous vide in these.
The whole idea is, I don't care if it's hurricane preparedness, because you could seal insurance documents.
Your cell phone if you're hiking or camping or going kayaking.
Yep. You know, and even things like compressing things for travel and protecting your passport or your wallet, or you just want to eliminate any possible spills in that carry-on or that bag.
Or old photographs. If you want to keep the air and the oxygen off of old photographs or film negatives, pop them inside, remove the air. Now, I'm never going to ask you to buy double A's or triple A's for this. You don't ever have to buy batteries for this. It sits on its base. And charges overnight. So I charge mine like once every third month.
Okay.
That's when I lose the charge. You'll start to feel it losing a charge. And then you just pop it, you know, on the charger. The charger plugs in. And then that tie, you know, that little zip thing that I was telling you about that zips right across the top of the bag, it sits on board your charger. So you're never going to lose that either.
Okay.
So it's a really sophisticated system that doesn't cost hundreds of dollars.
No, and it's very, very compact. In fact, I
utensil drawer. I keep mine in my utensil drawer.
Absolutely. But look at the variety of things that you can do.
There's nothing you can't do. We've actually done the little flats of cookies, still in the flats. So if you lose the box, or I mean, you can see there's that little plastic.
I could keep my Girl Scout cookies longer.
You could keep freeze your Girl Scout cookies.
Freeze my thin mints
here. Oh, the thin mints.
No freezer burn on
my
thin mints.
They're my favorite as
well. I know.
But you just take it, you go across. I always go twice for safety, make sure it's totally sealed, and then you can just start to see the air coming out of everything that you're doing. It removes it instantly, and it doesn't crush it though, right? Because if it was something like bagels or bread or berries, you don't want to use those big clunky food sealing systems because you don't want to crush everything. You want complete control. I have complete control. Oh, you can see all I'm doing is pulling back on
that
trigger.
Cool.
And I have 100% control over the air I'm evacuating. And every time I use it, I feel good about it because every time I use this, I feel like I'm saving money.
Yeah, well, you
I'm like, I just saved some extra
money. It really does. It makes me crazy to think that I throw away food. And a lot of times we do it. We just, best intentions. We wanted to save money, but we just didn't quite get
BOGO,
to it.
We thought we would get to it in time.
Absolutely.
Yep. Now, if you've ever purchased a sous vide from us here at HSN, I know Curtis Stone has one, Dash has one, lots of great sous vides out there, and you've popped them in your pot, and you didn't like using the plastic baggies, these are amazing in your sous vide. So you zip it across, and you can cook. You can see we just have steak that's marinating here. We're doing corn on the cob under sous vide. So you can use them that way. They're completely BPA free. They're boil safe, easy to use, nice and compact. It's not a big system.
No.
And you're getting 2 dozen bags coming to you. If I were you, I would grab another couple of boxes.
Get the extra bags. Get the extra bags. So remember, we do have both sizes available. You'll probably want to do one of each because, as Kelly said, you'll get it at home and you will really find things that you want to seal. All right, so keep calling on your Cuisinart. Speaking of Cuisinart, there is not a day that goes by that I, here are the extra bags, by the way. We have both sizes, which is not always the case when we have the sealer. It's sad because sometimes